Good evening, everybody. Good evening. Are you able to hear me? Am I loud enough so that you're able to hear everything? We're good? Thank you. And thank you very much for coming out this evening so that we can have a conversation tonight and engage in some important dialogue regarding your children and the Michael Strembitsky School. My name's Chris Wright. I'm the Acting Managing Director of Planning and Student Transportation and Property Management for Edmonton Public Schools. And before we begin, I'd like to start with just a few introductions. First of all, the MLA for Edmonton Ellerslie, Mr. Rod Loyola, is here this evening. We have the trustee for this end of town from Edmonton Public Schools, trustee, there you are. I'm sorry, Sherry Adams, my apologies. We have Mr. Darrell Robertson, the Superintendent of Schools for Edmonton Public. Dr. Lauren Parker, Executive Director for Edmonton Public Schools for Infrastructure. And we have Mr. Mike Suderman, Assistant Superintendent of Schools for Edmonton Public. Amazing job that Principal Michaelides and the staff at Michael Strembitsky have done in preparation for tonight and in delivering amazing learning opportunities for all Strembitsky students on a daily basis. And our discussion tonight is the first step in ensuring the ability to provide students with high-quality learning environments moving forward in support of great teaching that goes on in our schools. So I'll have some additional information about tonight's agenda and format in a few minutes, but I wanted to start with some context regarding demographics and development dynamics in the Summerside community. And so how do we know that we have enrollment challenges in the next few years? And what's changed since our last discussion a couple of years ago? Well, I want to first contextualize some of the data that the district has. As new schools are planned and requests go forward to the province for funding and are eventually approved. And as with many new communities, we must rely on some civic planning documents to project student numbers since large portions of the community are not yet developed. Now, at the time of our planning efforts and the funding approval from the province, we would have had actual enrollment numbers that were less than a third, likely, of what they are now, and a projected student count for EPSB students total of approximately 1,100 at build-out for Summerside. Well, today we have nearly 1,600 EPSB students in Summerside, which is about 43% higher than anticipated, and another 400 lots coming on just south of the school here. And there's a number of instances around the city where this increase of over-projected students happens. And it's not a result of any oversight or malice on anybody's part. Development and housing markets fluctuate, as many of you know, all the time. And so the development plans in a community shift in response to that. And over the life of a development, a number of amendments and plan documents can take place as developers and home builders adjust to market demands. But even since the 2014 Growth Accommodation Plan, we've seen some significant shifts in the Summerside demographics. At that time, the 2012 census data that we had available a couple of years ago captured about 550 0 to 4-year-olds in Summerside. That number in the 2014 civic census has jumped about 60% to 880 0 to 4-year-olds. So we have a couple indicators that suggest higher growth than past data might have suggested. And I mentioned briefly that, you know, there's some additional lots being brought on just south of the school, and we'll talk about that. You'll see those lots highlighted in a bit of an orange area on the bottom of some maps that you may have seen posted online, and you'll see in the breakout rooms tonight. And at some point, we're going to have to contemplate redesignating that area. We're not exactly sure where at this point. That'll be part of our discussion with you. Manissa's being contemplated as one option at this point. But I wanted to just let you know as well where students are coming from or where the demographics are coming from around the Summerside community. And as you can see, they follow a bit of a pattern, with the highest numbers coming from those portions of Summerside community sort of in the middle, and the east and west portions generating somewhat lower numbers. But we want to focus tonight on the Strembitsky enrollment specifically for our discussion, and our need to engage you in a discussion about some proposed options tonight. And that stems from the pattern that you can see here. our lower grades are significantly larger than the higher grades. And as you can see, our kindergarten enrollment went up 60% this year over last. Following the 2014 growth accommodation plan, kindergarten numbers went down from about 130, you can see highs of 150 sort of, to about 108 last year. So the pattern was back on track. But during pre-enrollment for this year, which happened last April, and during the summer, we ended up enrolling 174 kindergarten students at Strembitsky. Pre-enrollment numbers trigger an emergent request to the province for additional freestanding modulars, and you can see they've just arrived on site, and that foundation work is well underway. But the site now is maxed out in its ability to support additional modulars. And in an effort to roll forward existing students, with some growth worked into our projections based on the average growth at each individual grade level over the last few years, we see that the status quo becomes not sustainable. Again, Principal Michalides and the Strembitsky staff do an amazing job in programming for all kids, but we need to support that learning moving forward by ensuring that we make every effort to avoid having students in unconventional learning spaces. And I want to point out one factor that I think will answer a couple of questions as well. I believe that some of us are asking about, so why none of the scenarios have junior high students being asked to relocate that we'll look at specifically here in a minute. As you can see, with relatively few junior high students compared to the large cohorts at the younger grades, we wouldn't do enough to relieve future enrollment pressures by removing junior high. It would also cause a school closure action, essentially, because by removing junior high students, we would actually need to do a junior high school closure, which is a process governed by provincial legislation. And as a result, some junior high specific classroom spaces as well, CTS labs, purpose-built spaces, wouldn't be very useful for elementary programming and would be very expensive to retrofit. So we've not included junior high options at this time, as we don't view it plausible or our best move at this point. So as I mentioned, status quo isn't an option for us. The proposed approaches that we're presenting for your consideration and feedback tonight are intended to provide some interim enrollment relief. It's our intent to have Strembitsky at some point accommodate the Summerside neighborhood when space permits. Now we anticipate that the new Father Michael Moreau K-9 Catholic School in Summerside, I believe, slated for either mid-16 or September of 17 opening, will provide some relief to Summerside. We also need to see the implications on enrollment patterns in the broader southeast once the new Walker and Orchards public schools are open in September of 17. And while we haven't set those attendance areas yet, we'll be doing so and have public consult as part of that process as well. And so that brings me to the proposed options that we've posted on our website last week. And in posting these options, we understood that most people would have some questions related to the details in each option. But we thought it was important to at least get them out in advance so we could have a brief conversation tonight and then collect more meaningful feedback from you in the breakout sessions that will follow. So I just want to reiterate a couple of points before I start on the options. The first is that these are proposals. They're intended to generate discussion and feedback. You'll see a big effort tonight to gather your feedback. We're going to have some small group discussions, and there's going to be recorders there to capture all the discussion. I also want to stress again, there is no predetermined outcome. You can see that by virtue of four options. We needed to provide some plausible options for you to consider, but the final approach may include elements from different proposals or a new idea altogether. This presentation and all the slides will be available online following tonight's meeting. If you want to review the information, there will also be a direct link on the EPSB homepage that's going to take you to that webcast. And you'll find the link there as well that will allow you to provide some online feedback. Even if you provide feedback tonight in your breakout session, feel free to add additional thoughts online. All feedback will be reviewed and considered, and answers and responses to the common themes or questions will also be provided shortly in the form of an FAQ document that will be posted online as well. And so given that, I'd like to discuss the first option that you would have seen posted last week. In option one, the proposal is that all kindergarten and grade one students would be directed to SATU school. For September of 2016, this would be kindergarten only and would expand to be K-1 for September 2017. For grade two, students residing in the Strembitsky attendance area would be able to come back to Strembitsky and continue their grade 2-9 program. Grade 2-9 students residing outside the current Strembitsky attendance area but grandfathered to Strembitsky during the 2014 accommodation plan from Summerside West would remain at Strembitsky. And as with the previous growth accommodation plan, all non-resident students would not be able to continue at Strembitsky, meaning not resident of Edmonton Public School, out of town, or a resident of some other jurisdiction. And also aligning with the 2014 growth accommodation plan, yellow busing from around Summerside would be in place to support the K-1 designation up to SAT-2. And again, we're going to be covering these online. You'll have an opportunity to absorb some of the data and review them again and provide any additional feedback. So don't feel a ton of pressure to remember everything off the slides this evening. As you can see, SATU then currently has 8 available rooms and would be able to accommodate the K-1 students. An additional room could be produced by splitting the existing K classroom that you can see next to French math. If it appeared as though additional freestanding modular classrooms were required for the 2017 school year when K-1 was at SATU, those conversations would take place with Alberta Education well in advance. Now this slide projects the space requirements at both SATU and Strembitsky in order to accommodate students. You can see that Strembitsky will still need an additional classroom next year, but will have 2 additional modular classrooms and be able to accommodate a bit of flexibility through timetabling and classroom configuration. Once K-1 were relocated in 2017, the space is now available in Strembitsky. Option 2. In option 2, the proposal to have Summerside West redirected to SATU school, and this would need to include all students from Summerside West currently grandfathered to Strembitsky following the 2014 growth accommodation plan. As well, the northeast corner of Summerside, the pink color, would be redirected to Ellerslie School, meaning that all students from the northeast corner currently attending Strembitsky would need to be asked to attend Ellerslie starting next September. For junior high students moving on from SATU, the designated junior high would be Dan Knott. As with previous growth accommodation plans, all non-resident students would not be able to continue at Strembitsky, meaning not a resident of Edmonton Public School Board, out of town or resident of another jurisdiction. And again, aligning with the 2014 growth accommodation plan, yellow busing from the portions of Summerside that were redirected would be in place to support the new school designation. So busing from Summerside West up to SATU. And at this point, it's not clear about the busing from the northeast corner of Summerside over to Ellerslie because of proximity, but it is something that we're considering. We'd invite your feedback as well. As far as a Google Maps image, and again, an indication of some of the students that would be involved in this scenario, either from SATU and Dan Knott being Summerside West, or from the northeast corner over to Ellerslie, an idea of the student counts, and again, the proximity to Michael Strembitsky School. And our map again, sorry, our chart again of classroom spaces required. And again, like the last chart, for your classroom spaces, you need to look at the very bottom line, because what we've done there is we've adjusted the classroom spaces required for half-day kindergarten, because you can get 2 kindergarten cohorts into 1 class by using it AM and then PM. And finally, here's for Dan Knott School at the top, an understanding of class and estimated enrollment for the junior high following the designation. And finally, for Ellerslie School at the bottom, with an idea of enrollment and class configuration. You can see here that Ellerslie will require two freestanding modulars in advance of the 17-18 school year. Option three, the proposal is the same as option one, except that all kindergarten and grade one students would be redirected to Ellerslie School rather than SATU. For September 2016, this would be kindergarten only, and then would expand, as we said previously, to K-1 for September of 2017. For grade two students, for grade two students residing in the Strembitsky attendance area would be able to come back to Strembitsky and continue their grade 2-9 programming. And that's indicated again in the bottom with the dotted line around it. Grade 2-9 students residing outside the current Strembitsky attendance area, but grandfathered to Strembitsky during the 2014 growth accommodation plan from Summerside West, would remain at Strembitsky, the grandfathered students, 2-9. And as with previous growth accommodation plan, again, all non-resident students of Edmonton Public Schools would not be able to continue, and also aligning again with the 2014 growth accommodation plan, yellow busing from around Summerside would be put in place to support both KN1 and the designation to Ellerslie. Again, some data on classroom space implications. And this requires a little bit more work at the Ellerslie campus. But you can see that, again, there would be some flexibility next year when only the Ks have left Strembitsky, but we can, Principal Michalides will work with that. But at Ellerslie, we would need modular classrooms for 2017, a total of 6 on that site. Now finally, option 4 incorporates elements from the first two options and does ultimately provide the most significant relief from future enrollment pressures. Under option 4, you would see the redesignation of the northeast corner of Summerside to Ellerslie School for their entire K-9 program, meaning that all students from the northeast corner currently attending Strembitsky would be asked to attend Ellerslie starting next September. All kindergarten and grade 1 students residing in the rest of Summerside, including Summerside West, would be directed to SATU School. As with option 1, K-1 students attending SATU would be able to return to Strembitsky for grade 2. And grade 2-9 students residing outside the existing Strembitsky attendance area but grandfathered to Strembitsky during the 2014 growth accommodation plan from Summerside West would again be able to remain at Strembitsky. And again, all non-resident students of Edmonton Public Schools wouldn't be able to continue, and yellow busing from around Summerside would be put in place to support the K-1 designation to SATU. As mentioned earlier, we're not yet clear on our ability to provide busing from that northeast corner, but it's being considered at this point, and again, that's around the proximity. Some space implications again. Please look at the bottom of the chart with half-day kindergarten considered. For Michael Strembitsky. And for Ellerslie, at the bottom corner, SATU at the top with the K-1. Ellerslie at the bottom having accommodated the northeast corner. We know that we're going to have some work to do again at Ellerslie on modulars. But I want to tell you a little bit about next steps and a few closing comments here before we go to our breakout sessions. I want to thank you, first of all, for listening. It's a ton of information. And again, we're very confident that you're going to be able to access this online as many times as you wish to go back and look at data, classrooms, enrollments, if you wish, and understand it. But this should get you started on some engagement and some discussions in some breakout sessions. So thank you very much for listening. Please understand that we're very genuine in our intent to walk with you and your community as we plan ahead to support programming. And now we look forward to collecting your feedback and your questions and your perspective. In order to make sure that we're able to have all voices heard and be efficient in collecting feedback, we ask that you look at the room number provided to you on the map that you picked up when you arrived and to attend the session, please, in that room. If you did not receive a map, we'll accommodate some overflow parking or others in the gym here as an additional session, but I think we're going to be able to accommodate everybody in our 8 breakout rooms. We have a number of principals and staff members here tonight to work through feedback discussions with you. We also have a number of central staff members here tonight to facilitate and help answer as many questions as possible. If we don't have answers, we'll provide information through an FAQ document, as I mentioned earlier. Please keep in mind that all the school and central staff members that are here tonight are committed to supporting your children. We're all teachers and parents and community members as well, and we look forward to a respectful and productive dialogue. So I want to thank you again for coming and invite you to attend a breakout session, and we'll be making our way around to answer as many questions as possible. Thank you very much.